Yes. Number two, what should be the best response if the customer says it's very expensive? Right. These
So
are
much.
most common questions. So if it is very expensive, you can also do the same thing. Ask the question, what do you mean by expensive? Because it's not expensive for the customer because she didn't find the value yet, or it's expensive for her because she doesn't have the budget yet, right? So it's either of these two. Because even, for example, like a person who has the money in his pocket, he can even throw the objections like it's very expensive. Just something that because she or he didn't find value on what you are saying, right? That's the reason why testimony is the best story to tell, because that is something that very close to your heart, right? It's real, it's sincere. So yeah, so for example, you are a person with a lot of acne and then suddenly it got clear skin. So you don't need to convince people, right, to tell them that these are good. You can easily tell them that this is me before and this is me now. So it's easier, right? So all you have to do is to set a mindset. Come to think of it, all right? In Pakistan and in the Philippines, like we are not the first world country, right? Even in Bangladesh. But why in Bangladesh, forever living is growing? But they are not telling everyone that these are expensive. So if you ask the person, what do you mean expensive? And she answered you back and then sell the benefits of your own of the testimony. If your second option, which is telling them the benefits or even borrowing the testimony of somebody else, and even though he didn't agree, just considered him, take him polite, thank him politely and says like, thank you for your time, sir. Because come to think of it, not everyone who goes inside the mall purchase products. Not everyone who goes inside the restaurant, buy something to eat, right? So, but the salesman there or the manager of the restaurant, do you think he is very dramatic to say like, why this customer is not buying from me, right? No,
True.
so yeah, so you don't need to take this drama. You have to accept the fact that not everyone will buy from you. Not everyone will be pleased. Not everyone will be you will be agreed to you. Okay, so just
Super.
consider him as one of the person whom you got some practice, right? Because
Exactly.
yeah, because whenever I talk to a customer who objects about the prices, I'm just consider them as my mentor. Thank you for teaching me, to speak to people, to answer objections. So you have to be happy still, because if you are pressuring yourself and looking on the negative side of the business, like some of you guys says, I talked to six people, all of them says very expensive. I know what you will become. You will become failed in any businesses. Why? Because you're counting the negativities instead of counting the blessing on that having that negative side. It will have a blessing on you. Why don't you just think that these people teaches you to become better FBO or to become better forever business owner? So how about you, Upline?
For me, I love when people say that the product is expensive, to be honest. I always look at quality. I don't equate quality with the price, okay? To make it straight. But then when people tell me that the product is expensive, I would know that the person is not fitted with the brand I'm carrying.
Yes, correct.
I will fit my brand to the people who are actually into nutrition, into high quality supplements. If you tell me that you have this vitamins and you compare it to my vitamins, I would always say like, hey, I have a Mercedes. You're comparing me to, I will not name it, but you know what I mean? I will always take an advantage in explaining it politely to them why they considered a look at the product as expensive and reverse their mindset when they will understand the production, the quality, the ingredients, and the masterpiece of each product we have. So at the end of the day, we'll always come back to me na, oh, tama ka girl, no? Your product has this and that and that and all that. And then one day they try the products, they felt good about it, then they will place value in my brand. They will find money to purchase my brand. They will, and then they will be proud of it. You know, just as a short story, back in Manila when I went on vacation, there was a family there who told me that, oh, you are with aloe vera? You know, my grandparents are using the aloe vera, etc. They are quite expensive. But you know what? When I told them that blah, 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 then I realized, oh my God, these people are just looking at the brand because at the price of the brand because they don't know the quality of brand, the beauty of the brand, and they always equate the product into the price. Okay, ah, mahal yan, hindi ko yan kaya. Oh, that's expensive, I can't afford it. They cannot afford it, but someone can afford it. So people who really are into good quality products, they would understand why our brand has a certain price. Well, I will tell you straight to the point. We have powerful product. We have quality products. I have a lot of friends who wanted to try arginine. So I told them, try to promote yourself. Become an assistant supervisor so you can afford the arginine RG Plus super drinks that I'm taking right now while I'm working out. So I told them that try to do my business, enjoy 30% discount, and so that you yourself will enjoy the benefits of the product. So straight to the point, talk to your customer straight that the product quality is excellent, ingredients, how it is manufactured, how it is being planted and harvested. Just tell about it if they actually did not get the point when you talk to them. Yes, very yes. Good. Health is precious.
Life is precious. In addition to that upline, is it boils down still again to our belief system. So by simply becoming the user of the products, it will build belief, right? Mm-hmm. So once you're carrying this solid belief about the products, it's you cannot be easily shaken by different objections, right? Yeah. So similar to your belief in your religion, in your family, in your own personality, right? So you're carrying that belief. So nobody can shake that. Even your parents cannot able to, you know, to change your mind because you have that kind of belief, right?
Yeah.
So that's the reason why our company is always telling us to become the user first. Because it's really challenging to go and, you know, talk to these people. It's just like going to the battle and you didn't even carrying your own sword or your guns, right? So it's like it's very hard for them. Plus, it's about mindset. So if Mercedes-Benz and Louis Vuitton is in Pakistan and in Bangladesh, what do you think the mindset of the owner of Louis Vuitton in Bangladesh or in Pakistan? He has the mindset that not everyone is his own market.
Yeah.
Like maybe 30% of the market, Pakistanis are rich and wealthy. They can afford my products. But he don't care about the 70%. Right?
Yeah. Focus on your customer lines.
Exactly. Focus on that. All right, we are now on the top one.